Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today's card is pretty simple compared to what you are used to see here, but this whole sepia vintage look was a real pleasure to create. It was my very first time trying to make that effect, and in the end it was very easy. I first started by stamping the largest image from the family photo stamp set on Nina Desert's Tom cardstock using potting soil ink by Ranger. I stamped it twice to get a nice and crisp impression. Next, I started coloring. Like I said, it was my first time trying to create a sepia coloring, so you don't see it, but I had the same image stamped on the same paper on the side, and before coloring on the real panel, I tried the colors on my practice panel. Obviously, alcohol markers don't react the same way on craft or white cardstock, so it was a good thing to try the color combinations first. My thought was pretty simple. I first pictured the image in my head with normal colors, and then, where the colors were the same in my head, I used the same color combos on the paper. For example, in my head the skin was pale, so I used EB1 and MB2 on Santa and Mrs. Claus faces. Where I was picturing red, I used TN5 and EB8. I colored Santa's outfit using the color combo, as well as the hat on the bird, the candy cane, and the color around Rudolph's neck. Now to the white parts. Where I was picturing white in my head, I used BG2, BG4 and a little bit of BG3 to color those spots, such as the hair, the beard, the snowman, and also the penguin's face and belly. For the black or dark grey spots, I use BG4 and BG7, for the penguin and also for the hat on the snowman's head. In my head, Mrs. Glass was wearing a soft red cardigan, so I used a light brown combination, MB2 and RB3 to color it, as well as the penguin scarf. Easy coloring for the reindeer. He would have a brown fur on a normal picture, so I chose a light brown combination, TN3 and TN5 to color him. And I will also use this combo to color the bird and gingerbread cookie as well. For his face, I used a lighter brown combination, GB2 and TN3, that I will also use for the snowman's hat and mittens. And finally, I used TN2 and GY2 to color the spots that were yellow or light orange in my head. When the coloring was done, I traced a pencil line a little bit above their feet to create the floor. Next, I masked the whole image and started working on the background. To continue with the vintage look, I wanted to create a wall covered with flowers, like the wallpapers our parents or grandparents had in the 70s. So I picked three different stems and filled the whole background. To add some interest to the wallpaper, I added a little bit of shadows on the flowers, but not too much because I didn't want it to compete with the main image. To create the floor, I applied washi tape along the pencil mark and used vintage photo distress ink to color the bottom of my panel. and I added a little bit of ground espresso distress ink on the edges to darken the floor. Next, I covered the floor with the washi tape and used the same inks to add texture to the wallpaper. And the best part was to remove the masking paper to see the result. All pictures usually have a frame, so I cut one out of a beige pattern paper using the Ocean Scene die set and applied vintage photo on it to get the same vintage look as the panel. I attached it on my panel using liquid glue and then I stamped my sentiment using potting soil ink. This handwritten sentiment was perfect for my card, it looks like Santa wrote it himself. For an extra touch of sparkle, and because I think gold goes pretty well with sepia colors, I cut four corners out of gold glitter washi tape and stuck them on my panel. And this is the final result. So what do you think of this sepia coloring? As for me, I wasn't very confident at the beginning, but in the end, I'm very happy with the result, and I hope you like it too. Thank you so much for watching. See you very soon. Bye!